Travis.
Hey, good morning, Mr. President.
How are you this morning?
We just heard now, I see weather to welcome you home and make you know you were going back.
You got a press conference?
Two waves.
Get a little help.
Driving us in snow. These guys in this area don't know how to do it.
Mike.
I know Lord spent the whole night in the couch.
Yeah.
I did, I had a cooking bottle of champagne.
Well, this was a lot more dangerous than out here last night on the streets of Washington. In Central America, I was rising. That's your thing, the high ranch in California is the best place.
Charlie's headed down that region. Most of the fun.
That'll feature.
It's just that.
Yeah.
We have five blocks from home before we started seeing cars totally blocking the roads. And in 1 hour, we hadn't yet made our way back. We got in five blocks, we turned around, started trying to get back home. And it took us about an hour and 20 minutes to make it that 5 blocks back. That's
Feliz Navidad a ustedes desde la Casa Blanca. I want to take this opportunity to wish all Americans of Hispanic descent a happy holiday. This is the season when all of us appreciate our families and loved ones. It's a time of year when we take account of all the things for which we have to be grateful, not the least of which is our precious freedom of religion. We who live in the Western Hemisphere, from Alaska to the tip of Tierra del Fuego, are a little closer at Christmas time because all of us are of the same heritage. We are all Americans. I would like to ask you to join me in praying for peace in the coming year. We can also pray for our many servicemen and women who are away from home this holiday season. They are standing guard to protect our freedom, and we can all be proud of them. I wish you a happy and joy-filled new year. Que Dios los bendiga a todos. Muchas gracias.
Very good. Next hand. Merry Christmas, Mr. President. My husband, Bill Hughes.
Merry Christmas.
This is Billy.
Who's Billy's not
here with us. Okay. And this is Annie and Woodruff Hughes, who,
No!
Okay. Is that right? You can't get them to pay any attention to the President of the United States?
I know what you want, Billy. Billy doesn't want to
go on your knees.
What jelly beans, Mr. President?
I wouldn't get a jar of jelly beans.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
Yes.
Pumpkin, can you say hi? Can you say hi?
Hi.
Can you say hi? That and the fire. She's 8 months old.
Has anybody ever seen her again? That's pretty interesting, isn't it?
She's heading up to Illinois for Christmas. I was born in a small town in Illinois, and we're heading in Glencoe, north of Chicago. We're heading, my mom sent us rice, good time for a little while to go. Hey, Bill. What's that? What did you say? He's a great fan of your
comedy. Ted.
Ted?
This is the jar.
Oh, thank you. My gosh.
Seal. Yeah. Seal is in the jar, too.
Now, can I put my this on my desk at Capitol Hill, and will I get more storage that way?
Oh, you might get sabotaged.
That's what she wants.
Yes.
You might get like that? Oh, that's a wonderful Christmas.
And this is just a souvenir, so you won't go completely over to the enemy.
Oh. Well, I'll miss you, and then when occasionally, when you're up on the hill, I'll shout a question from behind the press ropes.
Okay, all right.
Okay, thanks very much, and have a Merry Christmas.
Well, the same to you.
Thanks. Thanks
Good
very
luck.
Much. He's going to be the politician in the family. Oh, okay. We'll open it. Can you say goodbye and thanks?
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Billy.
Thanks again.
Bye.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Nice to see you.
Hi. How are you?
Very pleased to see you.
Nice to see you.
Jonathan?
Yes.
My Mr. wife. President.
Hello there.
How are you?
How are you? And our daughter, Tina.
Hello
there. Well, thank you very much. Thank you. That's very nice. I appreciate that.
Where should we stand?
Right over there.
There we go.
Thank you very much. We really appreciate it. It's a pleasure.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate this.
Running the nation.
Okay. Mr. President, we've got the.
Hello there.
Mr. President, Commander.
Mr. President, very, very proud to have you.
Thank you.
Mr. President, how are you?
I'm good.
This is Colonel Fred Bigdood, my executive assistant.
Mr. President. Mr. President. Well, there's a picture here.
Okay.
Thank you.
I wonder, can I get one with my,
yes, sir.
My DAV hat on?
Yes.
Okay. Here over to the Bethesda Hospital a few weeks back and visit the wounded from the Lieutenant Benito. I'll tell you what, we've got the same spirit that we got, and we want to make sure they get that positive image coming back from them.
Well, it's, I think you're a pretty good example of the heroism doesn't end when the battle is over.
Yeah, well, we just. Well, you gotta go on, right? You don't have a choice. Yeah. What do you feel?
You mean that book that Rick Iyer? Vietnam, so work with some that group of Vietnam
veterans. Vietnam Veterans Leadership Program.
Yes,
oh, okay.
The leadership program. He has written a book about his own experience. Mm-hmm. He was one of his hospital. And I have to tell you, you can't put the book, I can't put the book down. I finally can't force myself to read at night after. And I'm almost through with the book. And it is just, I hate to say action-packed, because it is all talking about his hospital experience. But it is just fascinating.
Yeah,
a wonderful book.
Yeah, I've read some different books on it, and some of the guys are going through a lot. This summer, the Disabled American Veterans President, we're going to be having our national convention here in Washington, D.C. And for whatever reason, the DAV, unfortunately, has never had a president at our national convention. And if your schedule would permit it, it's August 26th through the 30th. I've talked with Harry about it. And
that could work out.
The 26th, our opening session here at the Sheridan. So appreciate it if you'd be able to.
Well,
with us.
Time bar.
Oh, thank you. Well, appreciate it very much.
Pleased to be.
Thank you. Okay.
Dennis is being rather modest, Mr. President. He made the opening remarks at the Arlington Day Center.
ceremonies this year, and they were very moving, and he got very good marks for it. Spectacular.
Okay, thank you again.
Thanks for all your contributions. We appreciate it.
How are you? Glad to see you. You're the best president we ever had.
Amen.
Mr. Sanders.
President Reagan.
Hemsley.
Nice to meet you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Mr. Sanders is the president of the Gideons, executive director, Mr. Hemsley, executive director.
I've had occasion to get in a few of the showrooms.
I bet you have. This is a great honor.
Encouraging to us.
Great honor for me, especially to shake your hand. A long time admirer of you, President, and we really love you. Appreciate you.
Thank you.
And that's not the reason we came to bring you this Bible. We came to bring it to you for several reasons, but Mr. Henson's holding the Bible there. Unfortunately, we didn't have time to do it like we wanted to. We wanted to put your name and your title and everything just right on the front, but we didn't have
to. We'll still do that.
We'll still do that, but we had prepared this one by hand for you this afternoon in the Hyatt Regency Hotel.
The 300th million.
The 300 million copy. And what I would like to say to you is several things concerning this, of course. First of all, that we are glad to present it to you, because now I've written that by hand, you'll forgive that, please.
That's very handsome.
We are bringing this to you, of course, as commemorating the 300 million copies placed by the Gideons in 133 countries around the world. And that's at the rate of about 63,000 per day, 23 million a year, placing the Word of God now. From a very humble beginning back at the turn of the century. And God is using these portions of His Word to bring people to knowledge of Jesus Christ and that they can be saved. And of course, we bring it to you for other reasons. We know that you are a Christian and that you do profess to know Christ as your Savior. And you are looking to the wisdom that comes from God and His Word. And James 3:17, we have a verse of Scripture we'll refer you to. It says very simply, the wisdom that is from above is first pure, peaceable, gentle, easy to be entreated, full of mercy, good fruits, without hypocrisy. And that's a wonderful verse. We know that you already have displayed great wisdom. And one of the ways that you've displayed great wisdom, in our opinion and the opinion of many people around the world, is in sending our troops to rescue our people and the country of Grenada. And I have something that just came in the mail. Mr. Henderson just gave it to me this afternoon, that I'm sure you'd want to hear me read a portion of. It's a report from one of our representatives who was there just less than 30 days after our men went in and rescued these people. They placed 1,400 scriptures there. This is our Gideon representative in those few days in one of the schools where he went.
Here's what with the Nationals.
Yes, with the Nationals. We're using the local Gideons there. And one of the teachers in the school, I'm going to read it because it says so well what many of us in the world think about that operation. I think the message given to me by one of the teachers, this is our representative, during a school distribution sums up the feelings of the people of Grenada. Quote, the United States did not invade Grenada. It was a rescue operation, and as a result, we are free today. God bless the United States and Mr. Reagan, she says, please give this message back to the Americans.
They won't even
ask.
Well, let me have it typed.
We'll type it, send it to us. We'll send it to you.
Have you stepped this way now? Yes, sir.
Thank you very much.
See you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
This is another special one, and I just can't tell you how much your part in this has played, how much it's meant to all of us.
This is a
special edition that has your message in there also. And you'll find it right in front. There's the end of it. God bless you, and thank you. We pray for you every day.
This way, sir. Mm-hmm. By the fireplace. Elder Charles Bradford of the Seventh-day Adventist.
We're responding to the Year of the Bible. The Seventh-day Adventist Church is proud to present to you a copy of the Bible story. We have 9 other volumes, Mr. President, but I didn't want to bring that big package in here for you. You already won at the end of the day, and we want you to know that our prayers will be here. I bless you.
Thank you very much.
Yes. 11
I have the honor of presenting to you the 28 million copy of the Living Bible, which I had the joy of translating. It's been well inspired together.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate that.
Now, now I have the other copy of the Living Bible in a different format. And this one isn't published yet, so I won't give it to you now. But I'll send it to you later.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
Dr. Charles Moore,
on behalf of Thomas Nelson and Mr. Sam Moore, president of our company, Sam sends us greeting.
Very special. Thank you.
I am honored to present to you this King James Bible in commemoration of the Year of the Bible.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, I think I should tell you what before you go. Well, maybe we can all of us pray there'll be a day soon when that distribution of Bibles and the books of the kind that you brought, the children's story and all, they can go there too, and they won't have to cut them up and make little ones out of them.
Amen.
Well, I thank you all very much.
Thank you. Happy holidays,
Jason. Yeah.
Happy.
Let's give a little hand.
Merry Christmas.